This is one of the toughest defenses to hit a one-play touchdown against, but with this play, it's so easy. The second he gets inside of the safety, you bullet and pass it away, and the other safety is nowhere to be found as we get right over the top for an easy one-play touchdown. And if you watch 13 here, he's going to pull the safety out of the way, and nobody's going to be covering 18. He's just running down the middle of the field uncovered. He's going to cross, and the two defensive players that are supposed to cover him are going to set picks on one another to the point where they're pretty much both open, but this particular receiver is going to be the easiest as he's just running wide open down the field for another easy one-play touchdown catch and run. For the fastest, cheapest, and most reliable coins in the market with a no-band guaranteed delivery, check out my coin sponsor, MOXP.com, and use discount code MONEYSHOT for 5% off your order. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Sniff the Madden cheese as always. Got another breakdown of a brand new offense for you guys today out of what's become my favorite playbook in the Chicago Bears. I'm staying in the Chicago Bears because I noticed a lot of people buying this ebook, so there's obviously a market for people out there that want to use this. And the one I'm going to show you today is brand new out of the Gun Tight Y Off. Before I do, if you guys want to see more, you want more money plays, you want more tips and stuff like that, you can always check out my ebooks. Links in the description or the top pinned comment. You can download them instantly simply by clicking the links. So, the offense is the tight Y off. I'm going to make one personnel adjustment before I get into it because one of the most important things is probably to have your best receiver on the team in the slot position right here. This is going to be the position that gets the most work. So I'm going to put DJ Moore there and then I'm going to go ahead. Mooney. There we go. Well, Mooney's over there now. So we'll go ahead and we'll just put some speed on the field. We'll just put Vannis Jones Jr. there. And that's pretty much going to be your setup because a lot of the passing plays I'm going to show you guys, the most important position on the field is going to be this slot receiver right here. He's pretty much the most consistent as far as the deep passing plays are concerned. Now, one of the best things about this as well is the setup for the actual audible plays are already set up pretty much how I would like them to be. You got the choice pivot return, the inside zone, which is really the only run play I'm going to use, the red zone scissors, and the PA go slot cross. Those are probably my most used plays. You could always replace the inside zone with, the fifth play would probably be the tight end corner for me, but if you really wanted to, yeah, there's a lot of plays I'm going to show you. The mesh spot, obviously, is one of my favorite. I use that a lot. The flood drive. This is a very large scheme I'm going to show you guys. The read options of an option if you want to run play, the jet touch pass. There's so many great run plays in this formation. I'm going to show you guys all of them here in a minute. Then we're going to go ahead. We're going to start off with run plays because that's really the quickest and easiest thing to get through before we get to the passing plays, starting with the inside zone. Now, before I get started as well, if you guys are liking the Bears or you're liking the full breakdowns, I try to do at least one a week in practice mode for the people that really like to, you know, learn these things and break them down. Please make sure to be a subscriber, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. Other than that, as far as the inside zone goes, you can just run it just like this. But I would suggest motioning across this tight end or even the receiver. You can see how this just gives me a lot of extra block in the direction of travel. That's pretty much the only thing that I wanted to show here. And like I said, I'm not really too concerned with the results because typically, you know, I'm going to show you this in gameplay early next week. I'm not really too worried about the results, but you can definitely motion across the tight end here to create what kind of looks like a bunch concept and give you a little bit of an advantage in the direction of travel. You can see right here, I mean, that was, you know, sometimes I got to run around there because they still kind of shoot that gap. They still double team the tackle to try to get him out of there. So, you know, it's something that it's like it doesn't even necessarily have to, you know, to me, I don't have to make that motion. If I come to the line of scrimmage and I see my opponent isn't something that I like, I'm not going to take the time to make the motion to give him the opportunity to change what he's doing. A lot of times I'll just run it. But like I said, you could easily set that wall and get outside. If you notice, every time that I've made that motion, I've always tried to bounce it to the outside, which is really the goal. You turn this from an inside zone to basically like an outside zone, like a sweep. Now you also got the read option. If your opponent forgets to set that, you can always pick that and use that instead. And this can really take the place of the inside zone. You can make your same motion across if you want to, if you know that you want to treat it like an inside zone. But if you're treating it like you know, your typical read defender, you're just gonna watch him. If he crashes down like he does there, you keep it with your quarterback, and then boom, you're gonna have big carries, obviously, with a guy like Justin Fields. So not a lot of information to know there. But if you're not too familiar with the read option runs, you're gonna see right here you have. You know, you're gonna watch the guy, the Hutchinson there with the R above his head, and if he stays home like he does there, you gotta hold A and hand it off. It's really that simple. If he crashes on the handoff, you just basically keep with the quarterback. But most people will set that in their coaching adjustments to the point where you won't get to do too many quarterback runs. But a lot of people don't, so that's something that you can definitely use if you have a mobile quarterback. Another really good run though that I think would probably be my favorite would be the jet touch pass. This is something where if I see like a cover three, this looks like a cover two. This is not the best defense for this because that cornerback is gonna sit down or try to sit down this, but you can see I still got a couple yards. It wasn't a loss, and this is because this particular version you have the running back acting as your lead blocker, where there's a couple of other jet sweeps which aren't as good because the running back does like a fake
inside run. I'd rather run this one where I have the running back leading the path. And I'm also going to want to make sure that I run this from the open or the hash mark to the open side of the field. That's going to be the best way to do it, because realistically, I want to just have my fastest guy here, which I think Jones is, and then I want to try to get to the edge. Now, this looks like a cover three, although the defensive end totally shut that down by getting into the backfield, which, you know, that can happen. But it's not going to happen very often. You can see that was the first time. You know, they kind of have like a double team option there. And like I said, you're basically just going to want to try to get to the edge. But if you have like a man zero, this is probably going to be one of the better run plays against that. Like this here actually looks like a man zero, because there's not going to be a lot of help once you get past that cornerback if you can get outside of him. So there, the running back, I thought he was going to take over there. But like I said, you can see it's a good run to add in. I'll definitely mix it in from time to time with the other jet sweeps. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time showing these other jet, fake and the, you know, stuff like that, which you can do those as well. If you really have a user who's active, you could try to run the fake and then just take it as an inside zone. If they start chasing the motion, you could always hit them with a fake. That's going to be the best way to handle that. But other than that, it's really, they're all pretty much the same play. So, got through the run plays pretty quick. I will show you guys this RPO real quick, because this is a little bit more to do with the actual pass itself. So I like this play. I'm not really a fan of the slant, although it is there. It is an option. You can see I got laid out. That might be best against like man coverages, but against zone coverages, I really like the X receiver if you just throw that out right away. You see how that guy gets out and sends and just basically sets that block, how that receiver and the swing pass, or really it's more like a screen, but you can see how they really get out there to set that block. And it's a little difficult. Something like the timing is a little bit difficult. As you can see right there, I didn't mean to hand it off. You really have to like wait a second and then get it out. And even if you have a man coverage like I think that was, you can see how he gets out. I mean, the guy played down on it right away, but it didn't really matter because of the blocking structure. You can see how Moore is designed to get out there real quick. And I find that that's a pretty good play no matter what the defense is, but it really works best against zones. You can see right there, that was a man, and that's why I got shut down. But like I said, man coverage, I would say the slant might be better. Zone might be better to do this, even though there was another man coverage and I got around it once again. So like I said, this play is really glitchy here. And you also have the option to just hand it off, which obviously auto hands off. So, you know, a very good play to have. This could be your default run play instead of the inside zone, because obviously you're still running inside and you can still make that motion across and try to help out in the direction of travel. So this entire run scheme here actually has a lot of ability on the ground, and this one here might be the best because of all the optionality. All right, so I got through that pretty quick because I didn't want to spend a ton of time on that. Obviously running is not too difficult, but I did want to go over some of the quick passing plays first, starting with the mesh spot. Now, this is something I've gone over quite a bit, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it, but let's go and let's pick that. On defense, we're going to continue to go with random. Now, this is probably like my favorite goal line play. If I need a few yards and I know I have to pass, I'm not getting something on the ground, this is a really good play. Obviously, the double drags will get open against anything. The longer you hold it, the better. As you can see right there, that was actually a bad throw. I'm not really looking forward to throwing. I always try to use the team that the playbook is from, but Justin Fields' accuracy is just trash. So right there, we could just, you know, we could do that all game. We could get him open over the middle against zone or outside. Cover three covers is pretty good, but if your user is overly active, you could always just hit the B route over the middle. And realistically, the best route against cover three that should get open might be the running back. Against pretty much any zone coverage other than hard flats, you could throw it outside underneath, but there once again we had Hutchinson kind of causing a disturbance as he's getting in there pretty quick. But mostly you could just throw it out to this guy here, get underneath zones and get him open pretty much every single time. Doesn't really work too great against man, although against like man cover one and stuff like that, I'll show you in a minute, it can be a one play touchdown. And I think I might have that in a gameplay coming up as well. But like I said, right here, you can see how cover three shut that down pretty good, but once you get outside of those curl flats, he's going to get open once again. So that's why I said these routes, the drags, can get open against anything because it's really situational. So it's at what point. You can throw it early or you can throw it late once they get outside to the boundary. But this play here really has four routes that can really get open against any defense, with the exception of the streak, which really just pulls back coverage. I'll go ahead and I'll pick man cover one because this is a one-play touchdown against man cover one. If you have an overactive user, a lot of times they'll chase the drags and then they'll just leave the B route open right over the middle of the field. So don't forget about that. But against man coverage, I'm going to do something a little bit different. Against man cover one, I'm going to motion this tight end across one more time. I'm going to put the Y receiver on a streak because I want to pull back that that safety to that side as much as possible, and then I can drag the B route to give myself two drags once again. So now I got a double drags concept, but I also have the running back, which is the one play touchdown. If he runs into the safety, I think it's the safety in coverage. If he runs into the whoever's in coverage, actually with the linebacker, you're gonna see how he's gonna get right past him. For wheel routes, it's really about the pass lead. If I pass lead inside here, he might not make this play, but if you pass lead away, it's always gonna be a big play because that's your opportunity. That's where you're gonna get that catch and run for a one-play touchdown. That should work against just about any man coverage other than cover two. There's a lot of other plays here that have dink and dunk capabilities. And I'm going to start off with the choice pivot return because this has a couple of really good man-beating routes. So I'm going to pick that. I'm going to go ahead and continue to pick random at first. So this play here has a lot of dink and dunk capability, but the route that I like the most is going to be the B receiver. And that's because it's a speed out route. It's going to get open against just about anything outside, especially cover three like that was, cover four, anything where the cornerbacks drop back, but also against man coverages as well. This looks like it might be a man coverage. I'm not really sure. Cover two is going to be the only one where it doesn't. But you can see how that just gets open. So just run that to the hash mark to the open side of the field. Now, this here looks like a cover zero. I'm going to say the A tight end is going to be one of the best routes here against cover zero, against man cover two, but not against cover one because a lot of times a cover one will have the yellow zone sitting in the middle. So that's probably your best two plays on the right side. The B route beats anything but cover two, and the A route's really best against man cover two and man zero blitz. Although you can block, if you're going to go against man zero blitz, you can just block the running back. Now, if you have what it looks like a cover two here, you also have the corner route on the other side. I could put the X receiver on a streak, put the A tight end on a drag, and this will help me to get that open against cover two, which is something I probably would show in the one play touchdown section. Actually turned out to be cover two man, but that's fine because I can just turn up the field and get a play anyway. I thought that was going to be cover two zone, but it still worked out. As you can see, that's still a good play for that as well. But really any zone coverage, if you just streak the X receiver and drag the tight end on the hash mark to the short side like I am, you should be able to get this guy open against just about anything. As you can see right there, that looked like it was more like a cover four or something like that because that's safety, the way that safety played it. But like here, this is like a straight cover three. This is not a man matching thing. You're gonna get that every day, just as long as you get a good pass. I didn't get a good pass there because that's what Justin Fields does. He has that trademarked. But you can see against any zone coverage, as long as I'm on the hash like this, you can streak this receiver to pull back the coverage, and the Y receiver should have a pretty good chance as we get another bump animation on cover two. And we actually got a one play touchdown, which is something I was about to show anyway. So that's a good lead into the one play touchdown section for this play. So for this play, I'm going to start off with cover two to cover two zone, but I'm going to count that last play as the cover two man one play touchdown because you saw that it worked. It's going to be the same setup anyway. So this is going to be one of your one play touchdowns for Tampa two and cover two man. Now, if you know you're running this against Tampa 2 or cover 2 man, you're going to want to run from the other side of the field. That's going to be a little bit more important. And you have some options as far as how you want to pull down that cornerback. The drag is not the best option. If you know it's a cover 2, motion this guy across and put him on a flat. That's going to be a better option. It's going to hold him down better. Or you could even put him on a streak and put the X receiver on a flat. And you'll notice how the X receiver can get open for a quick catch and run 2 a lot of times against cover 2 if he's not playing, you know, the cornerback's not playing too aggressive. That's good if you need a couple yards, but realistically, it's going to be best to just work the streak to pull back the safety, and then obviously you got your one play touchdown to the Y route, which is going to be a very big play once again if I get some decent pass accuracy, which I'm not really sure why it's failing. The fact that Justin Fields is just not very good when it comes to pass accuracy. So I can block my running back. In this scenario, since I'm on short side, I can slant the B receiver or something, give myself a check down, a drag, whatever. But you can see how this is just wide open for a very big catch and run. That's why, like I said earlier in the video, you want to have DJ Moore or your best receiver here because this is where all the action is going to go. And that's pretty much it for the choice pivot return because, you know, that's not the best version. Like, I could try to create some other concepts from that, but that's not the best version. That was what I showed you there. It's the best way to beat cover two man, cover two zone, probably in the scheme, although there are going to be some other ones that I'll show you guys. I'm going to go ahead and move down to another good dink and dunk slash one play touchdown play in the tight end corner, which is very similar. It looks like you have that same corner route, but it's not. It's a different corner route, which is going to make it even better against a lot of different coverages. So let's go and let's pick that again. Pick random on offense. Now, this is another play where you can run it from a hash mark to the short side of the field, streak the X route. It's not the same route though. The corner route's not the same. As you can see right here, it takes a slightly different angle, and it's going to come in handy in other coverages that I'll show you later. But the real key to this play is the running back. Nothing really does a good job with that. You see right there, linebackers, safeties, they're all going to get pooped on if you have a good running back doing this route. Everybody loves themselves a good Texas route. You also got the B route there, which is something that could work against man coverage, but I don't really find it too great. I'll show you guys some uses for that in a minute. The X receiver though, you got that spin dig once again, come back over the middle of the field, going to work against man coverages, cover two, cover zero. Once again, not great against you know, anything else. The B route though, like I said, this route can get open. The B route can get open against a lot of different zone coverages as well. Looks like we have a cover three here. You can steal that. And it's kind of like a speed out route too, just slightly modified. And it doesn't get open against every zone coverage. For some reason, some man coverages. For some reason, man coverage does a pretty good job of stopping that. But zone coverage is not. So I would say your best man beaters are going to be the X route for cover two and cover zero. If you put them on a streak, the Y route will be just about any zone. As I don't know why it's not letting me put them on streaks. Maybe I'm hitting the buttons too quickly. But the Y route's still there for zones. You got your running back for man coverages, and your running back really beats anything. And then your B route's going to beat zones as well. And if you're on the other hash mark, you could always streak the B receiver, and it'll have pretty much the same effect as the other side. So you could always work the A receiver, but like I said, try to be on a hash mark. I feel this route might be better against cover two man, though. So let's pick cover two man. If you see, this route has a different angle that it breaks. The tight end is more of a traditional corner route. It only breaks once. This one here kind of breaks twice, which to me makes it a better man-beating route. Here you can see he didn't even get pressed, and he still got open. Even though he ran into two cornerbacks on the way, he still got open. You can motion across the tight end once again, too, and do the same trick, and it might be a better way to keep that safety away from him, although the flat route won't work. You'll put him on a zig for a check down now, and he's still got a lot of check downs with the Texas route from the running back, and then you can see, you know, it just might buy a few more yards. So not necessarily a one-play touchdown, but a very good play. Where this play works dramatically different from the choice pivot return is against man zero and cover three. So let's pick that. We'll continue with the Overstorm Brave. Against cover zero, I'm just going to motion this guy across so that I have isolation. You know what I mean? I just want to isolate him there. And you can see how he's already got outside leverage. If you have that outside leverage, that's game over. You know what I mean? The second that he gives that outside leverage up, it's just a simple, you know, pass lead to the outside. It's an easy one-play touchdown. And you can see how that motion creates the leverage, which is what makes this play work. After that, it's really just a bullet and pass lead to the outside, and you can have an easy catch and run one play touchdown every single time. But my favorite part about this play is definitely what it does against cover three. So let's pick the cover three sky. So against cover three, just put everybody on streaks. And I'm not sure why I'm having issues putting X on streak. I don't know if my controller is not functioning properly. But just put everybody on streaks and motion out the running back, run from a hash mark like I am here. And this should give you enough, as the cornerback is going to give, you know, wide open space here. It's just something that I put out in a lot of different plays, but you can see how you get wide open space once the cornerback chases the corner route. And it's really simple. Once this cornerback out here flows off to take away this corner route, you can see how there's nothing but like 20 yards of space if you bullet and pass it away from the safety, which I'm sure I'm already doing. Is the safety's already reacting. Now, next I'm gonna show the red zone scissors. This is another good play that has a lot of applications in a lot of different ways. I'm gonna start off with Tampa 2. Now, I already showed you guys how to beat cover 2 from the outside, but you can also beat it through the middle with this play here by putting the Y receiver on a 10-yard out route and the A receiver on a streak. Both of these are just designed to pull back the safety or just do work on the safety. You can see how this guy here, even though the linebacker did a pretty good job of getting back on the play, can split the center safeties. I didn't quite get the one-play touchdown, though, so let's do that one more time. Like I said, if you want to try to hold that linebacker down, you can always put the running back on a curl. That should, you know, do a good job of keeping him from getting back too far. As you can see here, we got a lot more space that time. So it's definitely a good idea to do that additional step. This play can also have success against cover two man. Pretty much the same setup, although I find it might be a good idea to double do the 10-yard out route just to pull that safety as much as possible, because the in route might get him in a little bit more, and you can see how we can split those safeties because the receiver starts with an inside release, which is gonna be huge. And you can see because of the formational flaw, based off the fact that this receiver is so close, kind of like a tight or a bunch formation would be, that he never gets pressed, and he gets inside release across both the corner and the safety for a very easy one-play touchdown with a lot of space. So that was cover two. Let's pick cover one. So for cover one, you can motion across either of these receivers, but the best one to pull the safety to the right as much as possible from where he is right now is gonna be the running back. As you see when they flip, now he's way over there, and that's because he has to stay somewhat close to the running back. So motioning out the running back is going to be best, and then putting the A receiver on a streak is going to pull back that safety. The whole purpose of this is you have to be on a hash mark. The hash mark's important. That's why you're getting that look with that single high safety, and that's just going to help to get this guy open that much faster. As you can see, the B receiver here, once he gets across that safety, is a very easy one-play touchdown. If you don't want to motion out the running back, you don't have to. You can motion across his receiver, but you're going to see that the safety starts, he doesn't start as far off center as I want him to, because this receiver doesn't pull him out as far as the running back does. So the running back's best, but if you want extra blocking, you can leave the running back in for blocking and motion across one of those receivers. This play can also have success against coverage is like cover three sky. Let's pick that. Now, there's a very unique cover three concept here that you can have by motioning out the RB route and putting everybody on streaks or fades. The tight end is going to get open right through the middle because the B receiver is going to follow the safety is going to follow the B receiver. You can see how this guy just gets completely forgotten. I went ahead and changed out my tight end to Tanyan because he's faster, which will make it even easier. And I also changed formations because if you're going against a formation like this where the defensive end isn't necessarily going to run into the tight end, it's going to be even easier. As you can see right here, I mean, I'll roll out a little bit for time, but he's just streaking right up the middle of this team there. And there's really nobody there. And we get another touchdown. So, you know, faster tight end, different defensive formation definitely helps make the play that much easier. And if you watch 13 here, he's going to pull the safety out of the way and nobody's going to be covering 18. So he's just running down the middle of the field uncovered. Play also has success against cover four, so let's pick cover four quarters. If I can go back to a different formation, cover four match, it's going to have the same effect against cover four. All you really have to do is motion out the running back the same way, put the A tight end on a streak, and then I'm going to put the Y and X receivers on curls just to hold that cornerback and safety in place. Like I said, I forgot to put the A route on a streak, but that's the play. And then the A receiver tight end is going to put these guys in conflict. As you can see here, once again, nobody's covering them. I was throwing on the run a little bit there, but you can see how it's an easy one-play touchdown. We'll have to do that again, as I just don't really have a good quarterback, but that's just kind of how the game is. So let's do that one more time. I guess I'll slide my protection because I really would like to roll out, but I don't really have to. I mean, I get plenty of protection from the pocket, as you can see right here. I mean, there is a guy eventually coming over, but it's a very easy play. This play also has a lot of success against cover four regular. I had to back out and pick a playbook that actually had cover four, though, because Detroit doesn't. But cover four drop. Against cover four, just put the X receiver on a curl, the Y receiver on a drag, and the A receiver on a streak to pull back the free safety. And once the B receiver gets inside the free safety, you can see how you can create a lane there. Although, once again, against cover four, run from a hash mark to the open side of the field, put the A receiver on a streak, the Y receiver on a drag, and the X receiver on a curl, and you'll see how the A receiver pulls back the safety. Once the B receiver gets inside, though, you can just bullet pass lead over the top of the free safety, who's staying down because of the drag and the curl. This is one of the toughest defenses to hit a one-play touchdown against, but with this play, it's so easy. The second he gets inside of the safety, you bullet and pass lead away, and the other safety is nowhere to be found as we get right over the top for an easy one-play touchdown. So that was basically one play touchdown against just about every single defense in the game, but so is the next play in the PA go slot cross. This is one of my favorite plays here. So let's pick that. We're going to start off with cover two man because it's not really a great cover two. I mean, it does have a cover two concept. But I'll show you guys that real quick in Tampa 2. This play doesn't really need any adjustments, and the B receiver on a wheel route can get a big play if you get a good throw. It's a possible catch and run one play touchdown if you have a lot of speed. You don't really need any adjustments because the Y receiver is going to hold that safety long enough. I'm just canceling the play action by hitting the right trigger, but you can see how that's a very big play. And I almost got a one play catch and run, one play touchdown there, but I can't really bill it as that. It's just a good play. This play is probably best against certain man coverages, though. So we'll start off with cover one hole. This is another play where I'm going to want to run from a hash mark to the open side of the field, motion across the tight end, put him and the X receiver on a streak. The B receiver, I can do whatever I want. I can just put him on a slant, just some sort of check down. And the Y receiver is going to be the play. As you can see right here, I mean, he got open really fast. And that route is going to get open against a lot of different defenses just as fast. I motion across that tight end because when he runs that streak, he can help to set picks. As you can see, these two defenders have a hard time getting around one another. And within 10 yards, this guy's wide open streaking across the middle of the field for an easy catch and run one play touchdown. Against cover zero, you don't even need that. Because all I really have to do is just, once again, shorten the B route, put the running back on a check and release. And I don't really have to do anything. This X receiver just gets wide open. I mean, I could try to make that same motion, set that same pick, but this is just like stealing, as he's another very easy one-play touchdown. This play also has a lot of capabilities when it comes to cover four. So let's pick that, and we'll pick cover four quarters. Cover four acts a lot like man coverage, so we're going to beat it the same way by motioning across the tight end, putting him on a streak, putting the X route on a streak. And we'll just put the B receiver on anything that goes over 10 yards. I'm going to say a curl is going to be best, just to hold that cornerback in coverage. That's all you really got to do. And then they're going to set picks for this Y receiver one more time. As you can see, he's just wide open as the DBs were running into each other once again for a very easy one-play touchdown. And this play is going to work the exact same way, where you're going to see he's going to cross, and the two defensive players that are supposed to cover him are going to set picks on one another to the point where they're pretty much both open. But this particular receiver is going to be the easiest, as he's just running wide open down the field for a another easy one play touchdown catch and run. I'm gonna get him to end the video there. If you guys want to see more videos from the Bears or more full breakdowns, make sure to be a subscriber, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. My shit out.
Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my vids and more. Link in the description below.